This photo was a lot of fun to take, but super challenging to take, and there was not much time to take it. This is a wasp sitting on the edge of my trash can outside. It was, like maybe 5 o'clock in early November. The sun was going down, and we had to get the kids inside, get dinner going. And I wanted to, I went inside, and I noticed that the kitchen trash is full. So I quick changed the trash, and I grabbed the bag out of the kitchen trash and went outside and was going to put it in the trash bin. Nothing special, right? Well, I see this wasp hanging around on top of the trash can, and he was alive, but he wasn't moving around that much. Maybe it was too cold. Maybe he was tired. I don't know anything about wasps. I know about as much about wasps as I know about gardening, which is zero. But because he wasn't moving that much, I thought it might make for an interesting picture. So I ran inside, and I literally ran inside. I left the trash bag sitting just kind of by my garage. And I told my kids, hey, wait, I got a cool photo. I'll be right back. And so I ran inside. My 50 millimeter lens was attached to my D7100. So that's what I used. And I told my wife as I'm running through the kitchen, like, hey, I'm going to take a photo. This is really cool. And she was like, what are you doing? And I was like, no time to explain. Got to go. So I ran outside with my camera, grabbed my plus 10 close-up filter and screwed that on. I didn't even try my plus 4. I knew that this thing was small enough that I wanted my plus 10, even though that plus 10 is so unwieldy. So I ran outside and he was still there. And I put it in live view. I put my camera in live view, focused manually. And you have like so thin of a depth of field. We're talking like millimeters here. If you look at the in focus part on the lid of the trash can, I mean, it's just so tiny. And it was so difficult to get anything even close to focus with these conditions, with this thing who it was moving around slowly and the light was going down. I couldn't exactly pose him or position myself. I didn't want him to fly away. So I kind of moved my camera. So I was in front of this thing and it was slowly crawling towards me. And I just took some shots. I wanted that eye in focus, but I also wanted the ISO low so that I could have enough flexibility for editing this thing. And that meant I had to use a wide aperture. So I shot this at I shot a couple at f2.8, which was just unusable. And I shot a couple at f4, which is what you see here. I exposed everything manually rather than relying on auto exposure. And that can be a little tricky when you're in such a situation like this where you don't have a lot of time to think. But my camera, my D7100, has a little LCD on top where it will show you if your photo is exposed properly. It's got this little meter, I guess, that goes to the left and to the right to let you know if things are exposed properly. And that was super helpful in this. So I was in live view, but I was adjusting the exposure manually and the ISO manually, which I usually don't do. I usually shoot an auto ISO. But I just wanted to get this thing right. So I dialed in ISO 400, 125th of a second shutter speed. And in order to get a properly exposed photo, that meant F4. And that's a really shallow depth of field. And so I used live view, which is really slow on that D7100. And I was able to get this shot and just a couple others like it. And I was kind of surprised at how it turned out. I didn't think it would turn out this good given those conditions, but it worked out really well. I don't know what to, I always like to try and have some sort of lesson here. I don't have a lesson other than just know your camera, know how to control your camera, and be ready for when the type of photo you want to take shows up, like a photo of a wasp. Be ready with the gear and the knowledge to be able to take that photo. And that only comes with practice and actually using your camera instead of letting it sit on your shelf or in your closet.